that don't last forever. So tell me what we're waiting for. We better all be in together. Being miserable alone.
Today, on the Good Friday Reflection, we'll be listening to Reverend Father Roland Onuekwusi, CMF, on the topic, Piercing Through COVID-19 Pandemic.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, praise be to Jesus Christ, both now and forevermore. Amen. Today we celebrate the Good Friday. We celebrate the passion and death of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Good Friday, a day that is normally marked with sober reflections upon the silence that surrounds the dark night of this day. And more still, we are celebrating this year's Good Friday in such a mood of dark night of the coronavirus pandemic. Let us reflect briefly on how Jesus' experience of this dark night of Good Friday pierces through the darkness of coronavirus pandemic of our day. First of all, one day there was, as this coronavirus rages, tormenting the world, forcing fears, particularly fear of death upon humankind, powerful and powerless nations all gripped with fear of death. I scanned through the different normally busy cities of the world, from Madrid to Paris, from Paris to London, London to Rome, Rome to New York City, to Melbourne to Delhi, Delhi to Lagos, to Johannesburg, Nairobi, up to Casablanca and the rest. And the story, lo and behold, was the same. Complete silence. It dawned on me completely that, oh, the world can almost simultaneously be silent, be gripped in a dark night. And the climax was when we watched Pope Francis stand all alone at St. Peter's Square while he was giving the Urbi et Orbi blessing to the people of God on the 27th of March this year, 2020. It was so moving an event that it reminds one of Jesus' experience in the Garden of Gethsemane. And so, coronavirus clearly has exposed us to our human powerlessness. And the question that comes up surrounding this one single emotion of fear that always underlies every dark night, as is the case of Good Friday as well as the case of the coronavirus pandemic. The question that comes up to me strongly is, what about Jesus? Was he afraid when it was happening to him? To respond concretely to this question, we go back to his experience at the Last Supper and also his experience in the Garden of Gethsemane. At the Last Supper, Jesus clearly told his disciples that he longed to eat this Passover with them before he suffered, and that he will not eat it again with them before he enters the kingdom of heaven. Particularly, this is from Luke's gospel account, chapter 22. And Luke goes further to explain to us that Jesus Christ went ahead in the Garden of Gethsemane, kneeling down and praying to his Father, "Father, if it be your will, let this cup pass me by, but not my will, but let your will be done." And we are told too that the agony was too much for him, to the extent that the sweat from his body were dropping like drops of blood. But after this experience, Jesus came out triumphantly, victorious. His fear was gone. He was able to put his fear to flight because he successfully put his Father at the center, put doing the will of his Father at the center of his experience, of the darkness experience he was going through. And with this, he was able to pick up the cross, went forth, and consequently died. And upon dying, he bequeathed to the world three wonderful gifts. By shedding his blood, he gained us salvation. While he was hanging there on the cross, blood and water flowed from his side, representing our baptism and the Eucharist, which are the backbones of the church, his body. So in so doing, he got to the church. And thirdly, he launched martyrdom. For while he was about to die, he was able to forgive even his murderers, which was first in human history. So he was able to achieve all this because he was able to put doing the will of his Father at the center for the love he has for his Father and the world. He was able to put the fear he was having to flight and successfully completed his mission. So, clearly coronavirus has shown us that we need to fight, bring back God, put God back to the center if we are to successfully triumph over the fear of death that grips us like Jesus did. So it is my prayer and wish that we, the people of the world, all of us, learn to bring back God to the center of all that goes on in our lives. For he is the owner of the world. He is the creator. Everything belongs to him. And we ought to give him put him where he belongs. And that also puts our fear to flight. And we become free and completely free to the honor and glory of God. So as we celebrate the Good Friday and consequently the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, may God bless you all. May the Good Friday message becomes once again fully alive in each and every one of us through the same Christ our Lord.